So, for everyone just tuning in, Haribuys, Bubble Peas, I am joined with my buddy.
Platinum Rhythm, what is going on, everybody?
And we are going to be streaming through the entire Kingdom Hearts series. So, I'm starting off with Kingdom Hearts 1, final mix. We're doing all of 1.5 and all of 2.5. Then finally, Kingdom Hearts 3D Dream Drop Distance on the 3DS. Obviously, for 358 over 2 days and recoded, I'm going to be playing the DS versions because we're not having a freaking 3-hour movie night. So,
but everyone in the chat seemed to like the idea.
I don't care what the chat liked. I can't do that.
Wow.
So, if I could, I would, but I can't. So, it would be like fan commentary over a movie. Like, we're going to get this started. Also, because of copyright issues due to the music, I'm going to let Sora give his little spiel, and then we're skipping. Gotta skip the intro. Sorry.
Hi, YouTube. Get on Twitch. It says make a pocket monsters.
Yeah. Also, for everyone watching on YouTube, all these notifications you see and the whole stream layout, this is literally what everyone sees on stream. And you guys get to see everything just late.
Rip intro.
Rip intro.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately.
Having weird, real, or not.
Like is any of this for real? Or not?
No. 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 Are you kidding me?
What?
I can't skip the intro cutscene?
Oh, you legit can't skip it? Well, that's a thing.
What? I could have sworn you could skip scene. Well, we're going to go ahead and mute the game so that YouTube doesn't be a butt. I seriously thought you could skip in this.
Wait, called what? Hold on, let me scroll back up in chat. Apparently someone called something.
No, I didn't know that, because normally when I play through the game, I watch it. You can skip it in Kingdom Hearts 2. You can skip it in Chain of Memories.
Just spam the pause button.
Hey, no, Kingdom Hearts 5... Listen, Kingdom Hearts Final Mix added reaction commands. So, forgive me for thinking you could skip the intro.
Hello, Blonde Platinum. I'm here. You'll be my background noise for my homework. I don't think I'll be able to watch the entire thing if it ends at 12 midnight.
That's
I don't think we're going to be here for that long.
Yeah, probably not midnight. Like, on Mondays, most likely. But here, I'm not entirely sure. We're just going to go till I'm tired or crash. Ripperoni and cheese, blah.
See, I still need to continue.
If Platt wants, he could sing the whole song himself.
Would that even be considered a good replacement for...
Whatever lies beyond this morning... Oh wait, nothing's like before, hold me, whatever lies beyond this morning is a little later on, regardless of warnings, the future doesn't scare me at all. Well, freaking riffs, nothing's like before, ow, boom, boom, ba don't, 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 don't. We're at the end anyway. it's just, I can't believe you couldn't skip this. That's so dumb. Alright.
If I can just say real quick, I felt like that this was one of the biggest problems with Kingdom Hearts 1. Like, not to say that Kingdom Hearts 1 is a bad game, because it's not. None of the Kingdom Hearts are bad, but... In terms of story and exposition, Kingdom Hearts 1 was the worst when it came to that, because it just kind of threw everything in your face, not really given much detail about exactly what was happening. And it wasn't until the later games that we finally got... glimpse and an idea of what was really going on and why this was all happening in the first place.
Dude, the whole intro tells you the whole outro, but you don't even know it.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, you don't, like, if, I can almost guarantee, like, back in, when was this game released? In the, like, early 2000s?
2005? I think?
Somewhere in the early
2000s. Kingdom Hearts 2 was 2005. I think this was 2002?
Yeah, but it's like, yeah, it's somewhere along those lines. But
anyway,
it's like
if, yeah, thank you everyone for the compliments on my talking.
Talking.
They kept saying, it's like 10 out of 10 best singing. And I'm like, singing? I'm pretty sure it came out in 2002. If it came out in 2001 in Japan, then it came out in 2001 in Japan. But I'm not sure. I think it came out in 2002.
Yeah, everyone in the chat saying 2002. But yeah, it's like if you had this game in 2002 and you were playing this game for the first time, if this was your first introduction into the Kingdom Hearts series, I can almost guarantee everyone that's played this game would not know what was going on and why this was all happening. And they had to clear everything up in the later Kingdom Hearts games. It's like everything started to make more sense in Kingdom Hearts 2, and then when Birth by Sleep came around, that's when everything was finally getting itself pieced together. It's like, what else came after Kingdom Hearts 2? That was when the DS series was introduced, if I recall correctly. It was like after Kingdom Hearts 2, we got introduced to 358 over 2 days.
You guys didn't notice it right away, or maybe you did, because I was kind of running in a circle aimlessly. Is that on stream? Let me see. Wait.
I'm watching you do something.
Yeah, this is what I get for playing Birth by Sleep in bulk and recording Aqua's entire story basically in one sitting.
Oh.
So. Yeah, I had to switch controls. And by no means is this a speedrun of any sort. I'm actually showing all the cutscenes. I'm going through the entire game. I'm doing whatever the heck I want. I'm not really worried about, like, the appropriate things to pick. It's like how some people are like, oh, pick shield or whatever. Like, I don't care enough.
If you were playing, to anyone that's playing Kingdom Hearts for the first time, in my personal opinion, I highly recommend that it's better to go for either the sword or the shield. Like, there's really no need to, have a boost in magic, all things considered, especially since you're going to spend most of your time swinging your Keyblade, so it's really just going to be a choice between do you want to invest your power in attack power or defense powers, considering you take hits and use your Keyblade a lot more than you use magic.
Yeah, the big key is, like, first of all, like, if you start off with each of the items, they give you the obvious power-ups. Like, sword, you're going to get, like, a slight boost in attack. Shield, you're going to get a slight boost in HP or defense or something or another. Magic, yeah. You would start off with 3 MP gauges instead of 2, which it's kind of pointless because you don't even get magic for a while. And then the only other thing you need to worry about is the level up stuff. So, like, the sword gives you the slowest, like, support abilities, such as scan. Like, I think you get scan last if you chose the sword. I'm not entirely sure about that.
Well, I wouldn't say you get it last, but you definitely get it later than the other skills.
Yeah, like in Kingdom Hearts 1, like in Final Mix, it's different. You get different abilities depending on different levels.
Yeah, I think depending on when you pick up, I think the latest that you get scan is level 21, I think.
Possibly. I don't remember for sure. Like, I had a lot of these memorized in Kingdom Hearts 1 way back when, but Kingdom Hearts 1, you got scan at level 15 with the sword, period. I remembered that. When I didn't get scan at level 15 on Final Mix, I was just disgusted. I was like, when do I get it?
Yeah, but as I was saying earlier,
so scan's first of, for the staff?
You get scan, okay. But anyways, I was saying earlier, in terms of the sword and the shield that you pick up in the beginning of the game, like, you really just want to, like, in terms of what you want to get, it's either going to be the sword and the shield. But in terms of what you want to lose, I don't recommend you want to lose your attack power or your defense power. So if you want a solid run, you really don't need magic in this game. You really don't. Like, magic doesn't become really good until Kingdom Hearts 2.
Yeah. Like, Kingdom Hearts 1, like, I'll be using Cure a lot because that's just how the game is built. And then, like, sometimes you want to use, like, Gravity, and sometimes, like, Fire just for long distance attacks or something like that. But
yeah, other than that, the only skill that you're ever going to be using throughout most of the game is cure.
Except against specific enemies. Like, specific enemies, you'll be like, oh, fire enemy, use Blizzard because it does way more damage and you get tech points, which is extra experience points.
Mm-hmm. I will say this though, since you picked up the sword, you will get an ability later on, like earlier than you would with the rest of the items, that easily breaks a secret boss in this game. I won't mention this if we're gonna fight that secret boss later.
Oh, but I'm gonna fight all the secret bosses for sure.
Okay, then yeah, with the sword, you pick up a skill a lot earlier that completely breaks one of the secret bosses. It makes it a joke. I won't say what it is just yet, but I'm sure if anyone in the chat knows what I'm talking about.
High-pitched voice. Wind! That actually is one of the few spells that's really useful in this game. Because Arrow is what it's called, and it puts a vortex of wind around you that basically cuts down incoming attacks. And then once you level it up enough, because you level up the spells automatically once you reach certain parts of the game. So, oh, there's fire. Now you can cast Blizzard. Now you can cast Arrow, Cure, so on and so forth. All the abilities level up at specific times throughout the game, and once it turns into its final form, you can actually reflect some of the standard, like, fire attacks and stuff, like long distance, and it just shoots right back at the enemies.
Yeah, wind is very good. Like, wind is probably another one that you're going to be using a lot in Kingdom Hearts 1.
Especially not because I'm on as cloud often. Mode.
Yeah, not as often as some of the other skills. Like, really, I only found myself using Arrow for boss fights. Boss fights and secret other secret bosses. That's really the only time you're going to want to use Arrow.
This is a little ironic. The question right now is, what are you so afraid of? Getting old, being different, and being indecisive? Really indecisive, because right now, even this is its own... Oh, whoa. There's no back option. All right.
Oh, yeah. Like, this... anyway. This plays another huge part in...
It does.
Yeah, it's like, basically, the questions that you get asked... Oh, actually, you should explain this. It's your let's play.
While I'm on it. Only because I'm on it. Like, because you're a little behind. Nah, I don't want to share a screen. There's a lag on my screen, but anyway.
It's fine.
Right here, alright, you're afraid of getting old, you want to be number one, you want to see rare sights. Like, those are the first three options for all three characters.
Right.
It says, your adventure begins at dawn. As long as the sun is shining, your journey should be a pleasant one. This is so clever, the way they did this. Because the key words is, as long as the sun is shining, your journey should be a pleasant one. The game literally, not literally, but it emotionally gets darker as it goes. So, like, it gets more evil and more, like, depth, like, dark depth kind of style the further you go. So, this is an experience thing. You start off getting experience and leveling up rather quickly here, but it takes a long time to level up as you get further in the game.
Right.
Like, just the gap in which it takes to level up gets bigger. Now, if you go on second thought...
You can rearrange the questions and to have it to where you your experience build changes.
And some things have, like, variables so that it'll give... Like, if you mix up the options, it'll average it out somehow. Mm-hmm. So, like, if you do being indecisive, and then down here at the bottom... Can I change it? No, being number one is not a big deal in this given context. To be strong. Hopefully it tells me the right one. Hopefully it averages and just says, oh, you picked the bottom three. What's it gonna say? Your adventure begins in the dead of night. Your road won't be easy, but a rising sun awaits your journey's end.
The road to dusk.
So basically that means it's gonna be really hard to start, but you'll be leveling up faster at the end of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm literally indecisive because I never know what I want to do. So, Platt, you decide. Should I go fast early or fast late?
Oh, God. How did I go about this? When I was playing through this on my channel, on my Twitch page, I got the early start with the Road to Dawn. But I don't know. It's like, I don't know if you, in this particular case, because you are playing on proud mode, right?
On second thought.
No, I'm asking.
I'm playing on proud mode on a live stream.
Oh.
I want to level up a little bit faster at the beginning.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea then.
All right, so. And, like, here's the thing. Like, I'm not editing or cutting anything out, obviously. Like, I might, like, post-edit something and be like, all right, I literally just grinded for an hour.
Yeah, everyone in the chat saying do fast late or do the dusk.
Well, it's a little too late.
Yeah.
Well, now it's too late. I literally just hit sounds good.
Okay.
The day you will open the door is both far off and very near. Ooh.
All things considered, it's not... Yeah, all things considered, if you know the proper place to grind late game, it really doesn't take that long to level up, so...
Yeah, I mean, basically, it's the latest you are. Like, whatever the furthest point you've made, that's where the strongest enemies are. They give you the most experience. Sometimes you might want to go to older worlds because they have new enemies. Like, you just really have to know.
Right.
Can't wait for the one boss fight that takes 6 hours. There might be. You never know. Hopefully not. But I haven't.
I think I know what boss he's talking about, though. And it's my least favorite boss in the whole game.
Oh, I thought she was just saying, like, in general, watch, you're gonna take forever on a boss.
Oh no, no. Like, there's a boss that really takes a long time to beat, especially if you don't
wait,
have
a main boss.
Like, not a main boss, a secret boss. Let's just say.
Oh, okay. Never mind. Oh, yeah, that's secret bosses, I know who knows? I'm gonna have to... Oh, there is one in particular that just drags out forever and there's nothing you can do about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I was saying. I think I know what that person's talking about.
That's my hint.
Farming for Ultima Weapon is the best way to grind late game. I can never... Okay, and I guess I can tell this story since I'd already beaten the game on my channel. Or my Twitch channel, by the way. I have not, in any way, shape, or form, come close to forging the Ultima Weapon in Kingdom Hearts 1 Final Mix. And the
Final Mix, okay.
Yeah, Kingdom Hearts 1 Final Mix. It is such a chore to, like, they're making you having to go all the way out of your way to get every little thing to be able to forge the Ultima Weapon. It's like, you have to go everywhere and get, like, every little thing to make the materials and stuff and the accessories required for you to add more to the synthesis list, and then you can make the ultimate, but you still have to go out and get the items for that. Yeah. It's not like Kingdom Hearts 2, where all the items that you need come in bulk, and I feel like the recipe system in Kingdom Hearts 2 make things a lot easier.
Way better. Like, there's some good, like, personally, I think you get better stuff as far as the game, like, the way the game is played. I think they give you some better items in Kingdom Hearts 1, but the synthesizing is way easier in 2, and then later on in the game, you can get some of the best items in the game from synthesizing.
Yeah, it's so, like, with the recipes, getting the stuff that you need is a lot easier, and not only that, the items that you do need come in bulk, so it's like, they're much easier to get.
Sorry to cut you off, but hold up. Hold up. Wait for it. Everyone's getting excited.
Are they?
Everyone's getting excited. Hold up. They're getting... There it goes. There it goes. Bill Nye the Science Guy. Oh, yes. It's been a while since I've been able to do that. Anyway, so here's the thing I like to do with this boss, so this might be a little time consuming. You notice I hit 2 hits on its arm. I really shouldn't have done that. I was kind of rushing. I don't want to touch him at all. I'd rather just take out these shadows that keep popping up.
Yeah, because right now, I believe they're your only methods to gaining more health.
Yeah, they're the only way you can gain more health. And then on top of that, he drops to his knees, and now there's a giant heart in the middle of him. He's going to shoot at... Oh, shoot. Bad timing. There we go. So now he's going to shoot all these orbs out of that hole in his chest. Every single one of the... How did the... One of those hit me?
Did they?
All right. I messed it up because it's been a while, and I wasn't on the right angle. But... Basically, hitting it back gives you one experience point, and then when it hits its head, it gives you another two experience points. So that's three experience points per hit, and then once you start shooting three or five at a time, there you go. You're just getting a ton of experience for free. I'm already level three, and I haven't even started the real game yet. I'm in the tutorial. So, there you go. And for anyone who doesn't get the Bill Nye reference, apparently you haven't watched my Kingdom Hearts series before. Literally, the line is, the closer you get to the light, the greater your shadow becomes. Science! So I'm like, this guy's Bill Nye the Science Guy. Don't swing sideways. Sora, you're gonna die. I'm literally gonna die because Sora decided to swing sideways twice.
I guess you could say the shadow's not really putting his heart into the fight.
See, now I think I might as well just kill him. I mean, I've already leveled up, so I've got something out of it, but still. Oh, hit
him. Unless you can avoid a few.
No, because I have one HP left, and the shadows are just jerks.
Time to die in the tutorial.
I think as far as speedrun tactics go, it actually is faster to die here. But, whatever. And it don't matter. I mean, it did kind of matter. I missed out on like 30 experience points, which is... No, that's not even a lot, in all honesty, because I have a way to level grind with Titus. So, like, that's the easiest way to level up, and I don't care enough. I really don't.
Oh, wait. You can lose the fight and the story will still progress?
Yeah.
Oh, I never knew that.
Because Sora basically panics. Like, any level... I'm sorry, not level. Any section in any of the Kingdom Hearts games where Sora eventually falls or says, like, this is too tough or there's too many, all those scenes you can die in.
Okay.
So, like, in Kingdom Hearts 2, you fight a bunch of Dusks when they first appear. He doesn't know what the heck they are. If you fall below a certain amount of HP, he'll be like, this is ridiculous, and then Mickey shows up. So, like, any of those situations... you're actually allowed to die. And forgive us, since this is a live stream, we are probably going to be talking over all the cutscenes.
Whoa!
So, they're audible, but we're going to talk over them. It's not a Let's Play video. Well, technically it is, but you know what I mean.
We're just having fun with it.
I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
Yeah, that actually isn't the first time I died in the tutorial. I died the exact same way before. So, that's why I'm not surprised, because if Sora swings sideways for whatever reason, I don't know why, but like if he swings sideways, he'll get hit, or the timing will be wrong, whereas if he swings overhead, you push a button, you swing a sword. It's easy.
What was your hometown like?
But,
you know, where you grew up?
Whatever. That happened, and now I'm going to have to grind an extra 20 seconds against Titus.
Nothing.
Oops.
You ever want to go back?
It's not like I'm actually speedrunning or anything. I'm playing through the whole game. It don't matter. We chilling.
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it. I'd like to
Kyrie
see it
too. Does have nice hair now that you mention it.
Any other worlds out there.
It's better in Kingdom Hearts 2, though.
I want to see them all.
Rini Pink asks, least favorite Kingdom Hearts 1 enemy, blah.
Aren't you guys
least favorite Kingdom Hearts 1 enemy? What are those armored dog enemies, like, with the, what is it, the shields that are basically pit bulls?
Okay. Oh, defenders.
Defenders, yeah, those are my least favorite. In Kingdom Hearts 1.
Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
They're just so annoying. They can appear out of nowhere, they actually do damage, and, like, the large bodies, the fat bandits, like, when they turn around, they give you so much, like, attention, like, hey, by the way, I'm about to attack. But the defenders, it's just like, alright, I'm gonna turn and punch you in the face with a dog. Have fun. And yet, eliminators, I'm pretty sure that's what they're referring to. Eliminators are an even harder version of the defenders in Kingdom Hearts Recoded. I've killed one of those things, I think, if I even killed it. Anyway, now we're going all around the island. We're collecting just stuff for the trip that we're about to make on the raft. They're trying to visit other worlds. I don't know why you would choose to build one medium-sized raft when literally all three of us that want to go on the raft have boats right there. But, I mean, that's how the story goes, so we're just going to leave it.
Probably not theirs.
No, that's theirs. Because, spoilers, when you get to the part of the game, Sora hops out of the boat. Like, it doesn't show him riding the boat, but it shows him, like, jumping out of it and landing on the island, and there's only two other boats there. And it says Riku's boat and Kairi's.
Oh, okay. Well, they probably need something that they can all ride on together so that they don't risk getting lost if they were to take the boats.
Possibly. That's the first legit reasoning I've ever heard about it, but still.
Hey, Sora, you feel lucky today?
What were those Heartless that was at the end of the world section? There was angels, there were the ones that...
Wait, are you referring to Angel Dust?
Yeah, the Heartless that looks like an angel.
Oh, no, the one that looks like, well, a demon angel, you mean?
Those,
I'm trying to remember what they were called, but when you said angel, I was like, wait, Angel Dust? Because those are the ones that...
Angel Stars, that was the name.
Stars?
I think that was the name.
I could have sworn they were Angel Dusts. Invisibles, that's what they were.
Yeah, Invisibles too, yeah.
No, not Neo Shadows. Neo Shadows are the shadows on steroids.
Neo Shadows are easy. Also, as I'm seeing on the stream right now, yeah, this is another good way to get experience. It's just to have bouts with Tidus and Waka and Sophie.
And what I don't understand is so many people are like, well, how are you doing this? It's so hard. Or like, I would level up by hitting Waka's Blitz Ball. Because when you hit the Blitz Ball, it just, like, goes over his head. It doesn't hurt him. You never do any damage. And I'm like, well, technically you're right. It's one HP. I'm not one HP. It's one experience point each time. But with Titus. I keep calling him Titus in Kingdom Hearts 1 because of Waka.
Yeah, Titus. Yeah, Titus, Titus. It's pronounced either way.
It's actually Titus, but freaking Waka does Titus in this game. So that's what I kept thinking his name was. I was like, wait, did they... They changed the pronunciation? What happened? But anyway, like, here, I leveled up twice in this one battle while I'm just talking. Now, ideally, when you've had enough, you just start swinging at him, you repeat, and then you hit him again, and you just keep going until he dies.
Mm-hmm.
Every time you parry one of his attacks, that's 2 experience, and then after you kill him, well, defeat him, that's another 2 experience. Right there, I just got the 2. So beating him gives you just as much experience as hitting his stick.
Yeah, as tech hitting him. So it's like you might as well just tech hit with or parry. So as the game likes to call it.
Yeah. So personally, like, all right, I pause and I'm level 5 right now. Typically, what I would do on the original version, I just don't know what level it is this time around because it's Final Mix. I'm not too familiar with it. I'm not speed running or anything. So normally I would sit there and grind on Titus until I was level 15 and I had Scan. Like, I would leave the island with Scan, even though technically I could level up a little bit faster later on, but I feel like being level 15 early on just lets you sprint through this game. So the other thing you might want to do is battle Riku, because Riku's really easy. He follows the exact same pattern every time. He's actually the most, like, predictable character out of the entire island group. Like, Titus will randomly run away from you. You never know. Waka will take a little while to shoot his hyper blitz ball, whatever the high-speed overhead one is. Selfie just kind of runs wherever the heck she wants. Whereas Riku, when he's blocking, you hit 3 times, you dodge, you hit him up to 4 times. On the 4th hit, he falls on the ground and does a kick-up attack. Just walk out of the way. He's literally the easiest person to fight in the entire... Like, once you know that's all you have to do is hit him down 4 times or get blocked 3 times, it's easy.
Yeah.
And right there, the reason he attacks faster is because he's almost dead. He's freaking out. So... There you go. So now the score is 1-0. I think the score only goes to 99.
Does it?
I think.
I doubt there's a I doubt there's a what is it, a trophy for that.
There might be, I don't know. It's either 99 or 100. I just forget which. I just know it didn't go past 100. That's all I remember. But I literally sat here and beat Riku 100 times because I was like, you know what? Free potions. I'll never die.
Yeah, also, thank you, Rini Pink. I mispronounced Selfie's name. I thought it was Sophie for some reason.
Watch it. Okay.
I don't know if there was a, I don't know if that was a mistranslation that actually said that Selfie's name was Sophie in like another version of the game or something. But I don't know. I messed up, so I do apologize.
Now, when Riku does this little kick-up attack, he will do about a third or more of your HP and damage on Proud Mode. So definitely make sure you avoid him at all costs. Okay, like that. Okay, that's one third. I forgot that he was about to die, so I kind of got hit. Alright. So every time you beat Riku, you get 5 experience points and a potion. So I advise fight Riku for the potions and then fight Titus for the experience.
Yeah. I mean, in terms of endgame fights, Riku gives the most experience. But with the way that Titus's fight is laid out, you can actually gain more from him.
Yep. Now, I'm going to go and fight everybody just for the sake of showing it. You really don't have to. But like,
Can you even fight the other two right now?
Yeah, you can fight everybody on the island.
Okay.
Well, except Kairi. She's not a fighter. Or is she? Alright, so with Waka, the experience grind thing is to keep hitting the ball over his head. Basically, the exact same thing that Darkseid was just doing, or Bill Nye, rather. Except this time you don't hit him. That's it. Oh, I don't know why he stabbed at it, but alright, it works. But if you want to just fight him to beat him so that you can get the bonus that you're going to get, then go ahead and beat him.
That really hurt.
Now I'm going to go fight Selfie, who is honestly harder than Waka, in my opinion. Just because how random she is.
Yeah. I think so. Like, in terms of difficulty between the three, I do believe that Selfie is the hardest one to deal with. But when you're fighting all three, Waka's the one that you want to take out first.
Yeah, because Waka will... Oh, right there. See, she already died, but like the way she swings her rope, if she just jumped out at you and hit you, that'll do a little bit of damage. I don't know how much it is on Proud Mode, but still, I find her the most annoying to fight. Now, I beat all three of them individually and Riku. So if only I could jump up here. I'm in Mario Maker mode where I barely have to tap and then I go back to the ledge. But anyway, come back, talk to Titus. You three against me. You battle everyone on the island except Riku.
Oh.
So what I do here...
I thought you could fight all three of them on, like, the second day you're on the island.
Uh-uh. You have to fight all three of them, and then that's how it works.
Yeah, it goes to show how long it's been since I played Kingdom Hearts.
So typically what I do is I attack Titus first so that he stops charging at me. And then after... Oh, shoot. Missed. After that, target Waka. Like, hit his Blitz Ball back at him, take him out, then take out Selfie... And then, at that point, level grind against Titus for a little while, and then when you finally beat them all, you'll get a potion.
Yeah, in terms of range that's hard to avoid, Selfie's the threat. Like, with Waka, it's a lot easier to dodge, but he has the longest range out of everybody. And I think Titus hits the hardest.
Oh, by far. Well, okay, Waka's Blitz Ball hits the hardest.
Well, yeah, but like I said, it's super easy to avoid.
Alright, so now I want to take out Selfie, who likes to run away. Oh, also, if you flee the battle, like if you're in the water or if you go under the bridge, it'll say, oh, you're out of the arena, you gave up. So, watch out for the water.
Oh, I think that happened to me once.
Okay, if I could kill Selfie.
Yeah, you see what I mean? Selfie's the hardest to deal with.
Because they're all running around and you're trying to avoid Titus's damage and they could just double hit you.
So I'm seeing, a bad I'm seeing swing. Her, Yeah, see, I'm seeing her swing her rope overhead. That's like the most annoying thing to dodge.
Yeah. Yes, all the characters... Oh, okay, I'm not going to say all the characters. The three characters we're fighting are all from Final Fantasy.
Right. Because it's Square, so they got to incorporate
it. Now, why they made Titus, like, 9 years old is beyond me, but... Like, seriously, he can't be more than 12 here. He's high-pitched, he's smaller than Sora.
I do wonder why they made the Final Fantasy characters younger. Well, in terms of Destiny Island's Final Fantasy characters, because everyone
Maybe
else...
because seems they were meant to... who knows, they might have had a bigger role planned at the beginning. Because you see Selphie in Kingdom Hearts 2. And she's, like, older.
Oh, yeah, she's friends with...
Kairi.
Yeah, because she and Kairi are still...
Right. But, like, who knows? They might have had a bigger, like, planned thing.
And yet we never see Tidus and Waka.
Yeah.
In Kingdom Hearts 2.
So there you go. By beating all three of them, you get a potion. But if you want a potion grind, I would fight Riku. If you want a level grind, it might be good to beat all three of them. So then when you're finally done fighting Tidus... you get a potion at the end of it, just for doing it.
Right.
So, if anyone has any questions, if we don't address it, just ask it again, and hopefully we'll see it the second time. Like, I saw Fat Dupley ask a little while ago, Blah, do you ever, do you like a fan, okay, do I like fan art, and do I let people send me things? Fan art, absolutely, the easiest way to send me fan art is on Twitter. Sending me physical things, like, in the mail... I do not have a P.O. box, because P.O. boxes cost money. So, if anybody wants to send me stuff, we better start a freaking fundraiser and get me a P.O. box for a year. So, not yet. Anyway, so... Alright, what am I missing? I don't think I got everything.
Okay, you picked up the cloth. You picked up two logs.
Oh, I did get everything. I wasn't paying attention. I was getting everything as I went. I wasn't really paying attention.
Oh, okay.
So what level am I and how long is it going to take? I'm level 6. It's going to take 22.
I remember when Kingdom Hearts 1 was in development, Sora was supposed to be a lion/human hybrid, and instead the Keyblade used a chainsaw. Oh, yeah. That's actually true. I actually do have the Kingdom Hearts 1 art book, the special edition art book. And yeah, they showed what Sora's beta design was actually supposed to look like.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm at myself because I'm not grabbing the edges like I'm trying to.
Matter of fact, let me grab this book right now.
Yeah, I actually had it myself. Here's the funny thing. Before the stream started, 20 minutes. I spent 20 minutes looking for Kingdom Hearts 1.5. I forgot that the disc went in the art book.
Oh, yeah, I think that was really cool. Like, the actual disc is actually inside the art book, like...
It's really cool, but I freaking forgot because 2.5 didn't have something like that as far as I know.
Well, they had special edition stuff, but...
I don't think the case was in a freaking art book or anything.
Yeah. Oh, I don't think I told the story about exactly how I got this special edition art book. I went to the mall one day to pick up this game just because, this game is out. And I hadn't picked it up when it first came out, so I was like, I might as well get it anyway. So I went to the store and I picked up, or GameStop rather, and I went to pick up Kingdom Hearts 1.5. And I think one of the guys who was working at that particular store was new because I had never, because if I remember correctly, you could only get this art book if you had pre-ordered the game. I hadn't pre-ordered the game, but the guy who was working there grabbed one of the the limited edition copies.
Are you serious?
Yeah, and gave me the copy that had the book in it when I didn't pre-order it.
Did he not know, or was he just like,
I don't know. It's like, I just knew that people weren't supposed to get this book unless you pre-ordered it, and it was just handed to me when I was like, hey, do you guys have any copies of Kingdom Hearts 1.5 that I can get my hands on and buy? And it's like, oh yeah, we got some right here. So he went and grabbed the one with the booklet, and I didn't say anything. I was like, okay, thank you, here's the money. Thank you for your time.
So you did know when you went and bought it. Like, you saw it and kept your mouth shut.
Yeah, I kept my mouth shut. I was like, well, if you're going to give me this limited edition booklet, even though I didn't pre-order the game, I'm not going to complain.
Oh, there was actually, me and a friend actually went to pick up, Mario Paper Mario sticker star. Yeah, of all the games.
Oh, yeah.
So, we went and picked up Paper Mario sticker star. This was before bad reviews came in. So, we go to get it, and, like, I pre-ordered at one place, he pre-ordered at another. So, like, when we went to the GameStop, and I picked up my Paper Mario sticker star, and he gave me the poster, he's like, oh man, I didn't get my poster. And I was like, hey, can you help my buddy out? He didn't get a poster from before, and, like, he's got the game right here. He's like, oh yeah, no problem. We have plenty. And I was like, they're not supposed to do this. Alright, and for anyone who's wondering right now, I saw like one or two questions, what the heck am I doing right now? Just because I'm leveling up kind of quickly, I'm just level grinding against Titus for a little bit. So here, I just need to parry 39 attacks and then beat him. I done lost count, so I'm just going to level up and then beat him. But after this, we're going to start on the second day. Wait.
I was like, yeah, I see the page where Sora's weapon is actually
a chainsaw.
Actually, yeah, a chainsaw. I think that Sora's design was actually supposed to be inspired from Squall, because even the chain, the keychain on at the end of this, yeah, because even the keychain at the end of his weapon is the Lionheart keychains from Final Fantasy VIII.
Yeah, like they admitted it. Like they, I think they said it was originally supposed to be off Squall, and then when they redid it, because they had all these arguments about whether or not like Mickey should be the protagonist. At one point they were like, no, Mickey should be like OP basically. Who should be the one you're actually gonna play as? And originally they were thinking about Donald. But because they couldn't even think of what to do, or they didn't know whether they should use a Final Fantasy character or a Disney character, they just made a whole new cast of characters right then and there that was going to be the Kingdom Hearts characters that you follow the whole way, and then everyone else is going to be a supporting character. Then when they started working on Sora, they did the whole chainsaw lion looking thing. But then when the whole Keyblade thing came to be, and how the Keyblade was supposed to be the overall weapon that most of the characters end up using, they reworked the entire character. It was like, all right, what's the outfit going to look like? And then the whole outfit is inspired by like the color schemes of Mickey Mouse.
Ah.
So like the big yellow shoes, the red onesie, kind of. The blue accessories like the belt and the wristbands, and then just the instead of like the black ears, you got the black hoodie. So that's what the whole thing was based off of. And then if you even look at Mickey after what is it in Kingdom Hearts 2, after you meet up with Mickey and then he shows up like as an assist, like whenever you die, he goes from wearing the organization cloak to wearing clothes very similar to Sora, and that's just what he wears. Like that.
So
Sora referenced Mickey, there, so. And then Mickey referenced Sora referencing Mickey.
We'll never know by staying here.
So I love Kingdom Hearts. Like they do so many little things like that that you really wouldn't think matters, but then when you really get into the whole series, it's just cool to know.
So suppose you get to another world.
EDM asks, When does the stream start this weekend? What stream are you talking about, EDM? Because I've got a few planned.
It's just, oh, for you or me?
I think for me, because I don't know if EDM was in the my last stream, but I mentioned a very special stream that's going to be taking place this weekend, and I don't know if that's the one he was referring to or something else.
And suppose there are other worlds.
So I'm just trying to get confirmation before I answer that question. A little piece of something though the idea was met with strange looks and dead silence, blah.
Wait, say that again?
Though the idea was met with strange silence and dead looks.
That's why we need to go out there and find
I was smiling at what someone just said. Was Emilior 5 said the only Kingdom Hearts game I played is the one on the 3DS. You played the last game in the series. So if you understood what was happening, you didn't understand what was happening.
I probably would have never thought of any of this.
So, thanks. Dream Drop Distance references every Kingdom Hearts game so far. So, people who just
Sora.
And that's what bothered me so much, because like so many people LP'd, Kobe, Sully, so many people LP'd Kingdom Hearts 3D, having never played the series or never really got into the series.
They'll remain like, a part of each other's lives.
Kobe no just said, I'm doing all Wii U and 3DS games.
I know you want to try it.
If it's popular or if it's got any sort of interest to me, like, oh, it's got Disney characters, I'll probably enjoy it. And he went to go play Dream Drop Distance. I'm like, no, dude, don't do it. And he's like, why? I thought you loved Kingdom Hearts. I'm like, I do. You don't. Don't get Dream Drop Distance. He's like, well, what makes you think I won't like it? You'll probably love it, Kobe, but you have to play the whole series or you're going to be completely lost. He played half of Kingdom Hearts 1.